Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2027, Troubleshooting VLOOKUP. All right, podcasting this entire book. Click the I in the top right hand corner to get to the playlist. VLOOKUP is my favorite function in all of Excel. And I always tell this joke when in my seminars, and it gets a laugh whether you're an IT person or not an IT person. I always say, well, look, we have this data set here on the left, and I can look at that data and tell that data came from the IT department because it's exactly what I asked for, but not really what I needed. I asked for item, date, and quantity, and they gave me item number, date, and quantity, but they didn't bother to give me description, right? And the accountants always laugh at this because this happens to them all the time. And the IT guy's like, well, I gave you what you asked for. It's not my fault. So they both think it's funny for different reasons. And the IT guy is busy. He can't get back to rewriting the query. So we have to do something to rescue this ourselves. And so this little table I copied from somewhere else on my computer. In plain English, what VLOOKUP does, it says, hey, we have an item number, W25-6. We have a table here. I want to cruise down through the first column of the table until I find that item number and then return something from that row. Right? In this case, what I want is the second column from that row. And then at the end of every VLOOKUP, we have to put either false or zero. Now, right here, after I choose the range, I'm going to press the F4 key, and then I want the second column, and then false for an exact match. Don't ever choose approximate match, ever, never, never, never. It's not an approximate match. It's a very special thing. It doesn't work all the time. If you like to restate your numbers to the Securities and Exchange Commission, by all means, feel free to use comma true or just leave the comma false off. But every VLOOKUP that you ever create should end in comma false or comma zero. Zero is shorter than false. You're supposed to put a false there, but a zero is the same thing as false. All right, now, troubleshooting. First thing, when you do a whole bunch of VLOOKUPs, it's very normal to have a couple of NAs, right? And I always find the NAs by going data Z to A, and it brings the NAs to the top. So right there, BG33-9, either that's a typo or it's a brand new item, right? And we got to figure it out. So over here to the right, I have the new data. I will cut that, and then Alt IE to insert those cells in the middle. It does not have to be alphabetic. This table does not have to be sorted. When you're using the comma false version, the table doesn't, you can just put it anywhere you want. I didn't put it at the end because I'd have to rewrite the formula. I just want the formula to work. All right. So a couple of NAs, extremely, extremely normal. But check this out. When you start out with answers that work, but then the NAs start to appear slightly frequently, and then eventually they appear all the way down, that's a sure sign that you didn't lock down the table reference, right? See, so here the table is moving as I copy the formula down, right? And so I'm getting lucky and hitting a few that were at the end of the list, but eventually I get down to the point where it's looking over here in completely blank cells, and of course nothing is being found, all right? So that's the first thing. You get a couple that work, a few NAs, a couple more that work, and then all NAs the rest of the way, sure sign that you didn't put the dollar signs in. Just go back, F2 for edit mode, select the colon, press F4, that puts all the dollar signs in, double click to shoot that down, and things start to work again. All right, next one, the exact same formula. The formula is perfect, BG33-8, we're getting none of them are right. Right, so I go, look, BG33-8, there it is, it's right there, it's in red, I should have seen it. So I come to this one on the right hand side, I press F2, and I watch the flashing insertion point. You see it's right after the 8, like that. And then I come over here, and I press F2. Oh, there are some trailing spaces there. This is very, very common back in the days of COBOL. COBOL, they would say, you know, look, we're going to give you 10 spaces for item number, and if you don't type all 10 spaces, they will fill it with spaces. And so this is very common, and the great solution here is to get rid of those leading and trailing spaces with trim, the trim function. So instead of A2, use the trim of A2, double click to shoot that down. All right, still the BG33-9 is back in the other table. All right, just so you understand how trim works, so I typed a bunch of spaces, John, a bunch of spaces, Duran, and a bunch of spaces, and then I concatenated a asterisk before and after you, so you can see what it looks like. When I ask for the trim of P4, we get rid of all the leading spaces, all the trailing spaces, and then the multiple interior spaces are reduced down to one space. All right, so you can see, kind of visualize there that they're getting rid of leading and trailing spaces. Any doubled up spaces in the middle become a single space, like that. So trim, great tool in your arsenal. All right, here's another really common one. If it's not the trailing spaces, then the most common thing that I've seen is where over here we have numbers, true numbers, and here we have numbers stored as text. And VLOOKUP won't see that as a match, even though 4399, this is a number, this is text, doesn't work. Fastest way to convert a column of text to numbers, select the column, three letters in sequence, Alt D, E, F. And all of a sudden our VLOOKUPs start to work again. Great tip from about 1500 podcasts ago. All right, so those are the most common VLOOKUP problems. Either you forgot the dollar signs, or you have trailing spaces, or you have numbers and numbers stored as text. All of these tips are in this book, Mr. Excel Excel. All of these tips are in this book, Mr. Excel Excel. Click the I on the top right hand corner. You can buy the book. All right, quick recap. VLOOKUP solves many problems. If a VLOOKUP starts working, but NA becomes more prominent, you forgot to put the dollar sign in the lookup table. If there's a few NAs, it's just items missing from the table. If none of the VLOOKUPs work and it's text, check for trailing spaces. You can use the trim function. If you have numbers and numbers stored as text, select either column, the one that has the text, and do Alt DEF to convert all those back to numbers. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.